guys, charmedwench here, and I'm back again for another time this week. You'll have to excuse the echo because we are currently filming in the dining room. This is something a little bit completely different for me. I'm going to show you guys how I get my hair the way I get it. So you will see my mum doing my hair for me today. So the person that you see doing my hair, that is my mum. So yeah, hopefully this will film well and I can use it and you guys can see what I do to get my hair the way I get my hair. And you'll enjoy watching. So if you want to see how I dye my hair pink and black, then carry on watching.
Right guys, so these are all the products that I use to colour my hair. This is a live intense lightener, and you put that on your roots and it just makes it really blonde. This is just a cheap pound black hair dye for the front of my hair. And then I always use Directions colours because they are the best. And it is in the colour Cerise. And obviously all the other stuff is just what I use to tie my hair up while my mum does my hair.
Crazy messy I look when I do my hair and when my mum does my hair. So we will be back in a minute when you can see how the blonde takes, and then we'll be applying the pink. So guys, this is the finished look after I've had my roots done. This is what I'm left with. As you can see, it is very crazy, and you can see how damaged my hair actually is in real life. Before I straighten it and things, I've literally just washed out the blonde and dried it. So yeah, if you are going to dye your hair, you have to deal with this sort of damage, especially with the amount of dyeing it takes to refresh bright colours. So what we're going to do next is we're going to take the Riche Directions in the colour Cerise. I have tried so many colours from Directions, but at the minute I'm liking this one. It does tend to stain like your hands, everything. It's crazy. My face will probably be pink when I've come down after washing this off. I'll try not to get too pink, but it happens. But what I do is use about a tub and a half of this and some of the conditioner. I know these have conditioner in them already, but I always add a little bit extra as well because it makes your colour go further, because these tend to, because they're so vivid, you could add quite a bit of conditioner to it and get more out of it. So I use a tub and a half of this and a little bit of this, and then my mum applies that to my hair, which is her favourite bit. She loves doing that. She loves seeing the colour go over the blonde. She feels like she's colouring in, I think. But yeah, so that's what you'll see next. You'll see her coming in and then painting my hair pink. And then I'll do the black myself afterwards, which is very awkward. I don't know whether I'll be able to film it because I tend to make a right mess when I do it, because my mum doesn't do that bit, I do it. And I tend to stain my face and hair, and you'll see after. But yeah, so that's what you'll see next. Thank you. we're going to wait about half an hour. I am going to go and throw on the black now, and then I will come back and you'll see what it looks like when it's finished. Right guys, obviously as you can see, this is my look when it's finished. This is what my hair looks like when I've done all the stuff you've seen throughout this video. Yes, it is crazy. Yes, I go through a lot of effort to get it to the way I like it, but I like doing it and I like having bright coloured hair, so this is what you get. I mean, it looks a lot better now. It feels a lot softer now. I've put conditioner and things in it. It probably looks a lot better conditioned now that I've straightened it and dried it properly. It does need a bit of a cut, but yeah, we'll get to that soon. But it's always better to colour your hair and then cut it rather than cut it and then colour it, because you just, especially if you've got damaged ends. I mean, I don't dye the ends of my hair, but it's always best to colour then cut. So just a helpful hint there for you guys, anybody that wants it. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. It's something a little bit different. A lot of you guys always pass comment on my hair or make comments about how my hair looks nice. So I thought it'd be interesting for you guys to see what I have to go through to get it to look the way I have it now. But yeah, if you did enjoy this video, give me a big thumbs up. If there are any questions you have about hair dyeing or anything like that, if I can answer them, I'll answer them in the comments below. But that is it for this time, guys, and I think I have a little friend that wants to come and say goodbye to you as well. Like I said, I have a little friend here, my little mini wench has come back because I'm filming downstairs and she can't not be part of it, and she wanted to say goodbye to you guys too. So go on then.
Bye guys, I hope you like my mummy's video, subscribe and give a big thumbs up.
That's it. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay.